Greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Madumekale bitsoleri Jesu.
I'm here to thank the goodness of God, of God of Charis.
Ki emi mo leboha bohulu ba modimo wa Charis.
Last week it happened that I come across an incident.
Last week i dela kala gore ke le katlakana le siemo.
Where the incident resulted me in a big operation.
Mo siemo se usile sampele cha sentishore keko operationing.
And then last week Wednesday.
Beke ofe takala bararo.
I was opportune that my case was allocated.
Kabale monyetla gore case ya ka taba ya ka ile ya hwetjwa.
They did come straight to me on Wednesday.
Did di batle straight go nna ka labararo.
They prayed for my operation.
Ba intapelele operation ya ka.
And this operation, after last week I was discharged.
Ka last week ke le ka discharge-iwa.
I didn't feel anything.
Ne ke sa koselo.
My body was dead.
Melo waka beki sa o.
I cannot feel, I cannot eat, even the food, when I eat, I cannot taste them.
Ne ke sa khono lo kwa taste ya di jo beki sa khono fila melo waka bo di thotsa ona be di hule di satla di bereka botse.
At all, my body was dead.
Nkama choma nkabula lo gore melo waka bo tlokofetse bo hwile.
But on Wednesday, when the man of God lay his hands upon me.
Kala bora re motla ka modima ba mpia matso.
My body begin to feel, to come to normally.
Melo waka wa thoma go phela wa bua sekweng sekeng sa wona.
As you can see the clip there. As you can see the clip. I don't know, they are viewing it. As you can see the clip.
Ka re le khona bona go TV mola.
That was the grace of God.
Ne ile ka mahao wa modimo.
I thank the God of Charis.
Ke leboga mahao wa modimo wa Charis.
Amen.
Amen.
Greetings viewers all over the world. Thank you for watching Charis TV. During the service today, Sir came to testify about what God has been doing unto his life, and he'll be introducing himself to us. Say, can you please tell us your name, tell us where you come from, and also tell us your testimony and how did it all start?
Okay, my name is Naftali. I'm from Mpumalanga in Bushbuckridge, Thulamahanshi. The incident, it happened in this way. It was last week. I took a local taxi. I was going to the where I'm staying. It happened that we have a debate with a driver for direction. And then after that, when I was in my bus stop, when I was out of the taxi, the driver went out also with a knife. And then he stabbed my side, on my right side, where it affected my lungs. Okay, this side of mine, that's where I was stabbed. That's where I was stabbed with a knife, where the knife went straight, penetrate to my lungs and damaged my lungs. And then here, that's where they operated. They open and check the damage of the lungs. Yes. My lungs were bleeding so much, so severe. Then I ran to a neighbor, where a neighbor called an ambulance. The ambulance came immediately. They took me to the hospital in Tembisa View, where they admitted me. Immediately, after that 30 minutes, they took me to the ICU. When they arrived in the ICU, they opened me. And then they say, my lungs is damaged. And it's severely bleeded so much. So it will cost me to stay for 3 days, my operation being opened. So I stay in the hospital for 3 to 4 days. Without food, my operation was opened without being closed. I could not move. I could not eat for those days in the hospital. So I saw the grace of God there. And then after three days, they came again. They say, I must go for a second theater. I went there for a second time. I was believing God the grace because for the first time, I didn't know nothing what will happen. But for a second time, I was scared. Because I knew what is going on there in the theater. And then they took me there, and then they operated me for a second time. After that, they checked my lungs, they checked the damage. They said the damage is better, they can close the operation. Then they closed my operation. I stayed there for almost 5 days in the hospital. On Friday, they released me. They gave me the medicine. And then the dressing to dress my operation. They released me, but even though I could not do anything, I could not feel myself. the operation was affecting me. I could not eat. I could not sleep. When I sleep, I feel pains everywhere. I can't eat. I can't sleep. So what happened because we are the member of Charis Missional Church, it happened that on Wednesday service, we came on Wednesday service. And I really thank God of Charis, because my case on Wednesday, it was allocated.
You are disappointed.
That's true.
You are facing disappointment.
Yes, man of God.
There's a time where you wanted to move from where you are staying, but still you find you don't have money to go out.
Amen.
Because you wanted to separate yourself from people.
Amen.
Huh?
Yes, man of God.
Because of disappointment.
Yes.
Come on. This thing must leave you. Come on. Come on, you demon.
Is it an operation, man?
I see operation, yes. You are healed.
The man of God came straight to me. He touched exactly there where there's my operation. I fell down. Immediately, I begin to feel my body. I begin to feel normally. I begin to feel my body. Because by that time before, I could not feel my body. I was just moving because I'm a living being. I was just eating because I am a human being. So I really thank God. And then after the man of God prayed for me, I was completely, completely, completely healed.
Let's go back to you being in hospital. You spoke that they operated you 2 times. And can you please clarify this? Are you saying that they operated you, they did not close the operation until they did the second operation? Because you said that they decided that now it's time for them to close the operation because they felt that your wound was better.
Okay, the reason for them to leave me for 3 days, it was because my lungs were damaged. They could not close. They were waiting for my lungs to recover. So after 3 days, there was the days they were suggesting that my lungs will be recovered. So immediately when they saw that after that 3 days, they found that my lungs is recovered. So that's why they say now I can qualify for a second theater.
And in that period of time, were you using any medium? Were you using anointing water? What were you using in order for the lung to recover? The doctor gave you something to use.
Okay, me and my wife, we are the members of Charis TV. My wife came with the anointing water. I was drinking the anointing water during those 3 days because I was not eating anything. They say I must not eat anything. I was drinking that anointing water. So I think by doing that, that's where God intervened in that 3 days.
And right now, as we speak, you said on last week Wednesday, the man of God prayed for you and you felt better. In that period of time, before he came to you, how were you feeling in your body?
Before the man of God can pray for me, I was in terrible pains. I could not sit for a long time. I will always stand. You know, I can't sleep by those times. So, but I thank God, after the man of God prayed for me, I could do everything normally. I can do everything normal. I was completely healed.
And as you said that when you got back home, you couldn't sleep because when you sleep, you feel terrible pains. Eventually, there was medication that you were taking. Was it helping you? What would really happen when you take medication?
Yes, the medication, we're taking them to calm down the pain. It was not there to heal me. They were there to calm the pain for me to sleep, in order for me to sleep. Because without those tablets, I could not sleep. But after the prayer, oh my God, I slept like a baby.
How are you feeling right now?
I don't know how can I explain my feeling. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling really, I'm a man now. I'm completely healed. I really thank God of Charis in Jesus' name.
At most times, we never see the grace of God that is in our life until something major happens and God puts hands. That's where you see that, indeed, there is God. And I believe this situation has shown you the hand of God in your life, because according to the way you're saying it, if it was not because of God, if it was not because of the medium that you used of the anointing water for God to put health in your hand in your life, you would have never been healed. I believe that you're in the right position to tell the viewers that are there. What are the words of encouragement that you can tell the viewers out there?
Viewers out there, what I can say, I know our nature, it's stubborn. Our nature is so stubborn. Up until God show us a way in a terrible way. Because when God speaks to us, we can hear. Up until situation come across, it's where we pay attention. We say, God, what are you saying now? So to the viewers out there, let's listen to God. Let's not wait up until we get accident. Let us not wait up until we get injured. Like what's happened to me? I begin to pay attention to God about what happened, because I was always running away from the call of God. But now I have seen that I must not run away from the call of God. I must just hear. So I thank God, because the Bible says God punished those he loves. So God was showing me that the way I was going, it is a wrong way. So to the viewers out there, don't wait for God to show you in a wrong way, in a painful way. Just listen to God, obey his word. Amen.
We give glory to Jesus for life. I believe that as you are here, the Almighty God has done it for you in Jesus' name. And I believe that you shall surely come back to testify that God, he keeps on doing great things unto your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.